first to breaking news at 8 o'clock. Thanks for joining us, folks. Bus drivers in Melbourne are walking off the job as part of a major strike action. Christina Hearn is there for us this morning. Chris, protesters blocking a major bus depot this morning.
Yeah, I'm at one of Dyson's major bus depots in Bundoora, and you can see the workers are still picketing this depot. They've been here since we got here at about 4:30 this morning. They're not letting any of those buses through. There is a huge line behind us. This is part of 24-hour industrial action. 1,500 bus drivers walking off the job. This is affecting two major transport companies, Dyson's and Ventura, after negotiations between the companies and the Transport Workers Union broke down. The union tells me that Dyson's, this is what the union had to tell me a little earlier this morning.
We've been negotiating an agreement with Dyson since December. We're unable to reach a deal. We've got a number of issues on the table around work and lifestyle balance. At this stage, they are withholding a government-funded wage increase from the 1st of January.
Now, while they're not letting any of the general buses through, the union is allowing the specialist buses through, the specialist school buses through, but that's it. And they tell me that they will be here all day as they continue this strike, Carl.
Christina, thank you.
The Labor leader is backing its Labor Party, I should say, is backing its leader this morning after Anthony Albanese couldn't answer a question about one of his own policies. Deputy Leader Richard Miles and Defence Minister Peter Dutton were on the show earlier.
This is not a pop quiz. This is an election campaign. We're not trying to elect a competitor for sale of the century. We're electing a Prime Minister.
He is a huge risk, and I think Australians are weighing that up at the moment. And why would you risk what we've got in our country at the moment to a complete unknown, and frankly somebody who's demonstrating on a daily basis that he's not up to the task?
Jonathan Kersley joins us from Sydney now. Jono, the Prime Minister will try to exploit this stumble today, I suspect.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how the Prime Minister handles it. He's over in the West Coast, Anthony Albanese over in the East in Sydney today. This is actually the bus that is carrying the travelling media following Anthony Albanese's campaign, about to board and head off for the first job of the day, a day after Anthony Albanese had a day he perhaps he'd rather forget, not knowing that six-point plan on the National Disability Insurance Scheme that he announced a little more than 2 weeks ago. Now, the issue with Mr Albanese for this is it might just solidify in the minds of voters that he is not always across the detail and not always across the brief, as some of his colleagues quietly say. He will be facing questions on this issue later on today. We've heard staunch defences, as you heard there, from Deputy Labor Leader Richard Miles, as well as ALP National President Wayne Swan. Last night, Mr Albanese, appearing on the ABC's Q&A program, said that he wasn't given the opportunity to answer the question. He was given multiple opportunities. And the other issue with this is it goes back to week one of the campaign, when Anthony Albanese did not know the Reserve Bank cash rate and he did not know Australia's unemployment rate. At the time, he said he made a mistake, he's human, and when he makes a mistake, he'll fess up. So, will he fess up today?
So you asked him all those horrible questions yesterday, John. Are you going to be on the bus with him today? It's going to be totes orcs, isn't it?
As the kids say.
Well, the wheels on the bus and the wheels on the election campaign go round and round.
Exactly. Thanks, Jono.
Breaking news this hour. One man is dead after a two-car crash in Brisbane's inner west. Police say the cars collided head-on in Baden earlier this morning. Jubilee Terrace will be closed for the next hour.
Now, it's hard to imagine how distressing it is for the family of Tani Shanks right now. This is an incredible mystery, this. The 32-year-old from Whitsundays is missing in Mexico with her partner.
Her daughter, 2-year-old Adeline, was found barefoot wandering alone on the streets of Cancun. Members of the family are now travelling to Mexico to look after Adeline and to try and find some answers. And we're joined now by Tani's brother, Dan. Dan, we can't imagine what you and the family are going through right now, how stressful it is. We're just sort of trying to work out what's happened here. Can you sort of take us through and talk us through the story?
Yes, we've got bugger all information at the moment, but what we do know is her partner is the one who has dumped Adeline outside the church. We've got three eyewitnesses telling us that, verifying that it was him. And Tani's the one missing, and he's on the run as far as we're concerned. So it's, yeah, devastating.
Look, we didn't know any of those details, and you talking to us like this and to the country, I really thank you for it. I'm just trying to shed some light on all this. How is Adeline? What's going on with her?
Adeline's safe and being looked after at the moment. She's at the DIF in Cancun. We've had the embassy send us photos of her and where she's staying. She's clothed and looked after and, looks in good health.
How did they get in touch with you? I guess just, you know, from where this started, how did they actually reach out to you?
So social media. We've had a friend of ours send us a photo that had been posted on one of the Cancun social media sites and said, "Is this your niece?" You know, and we were woken up in the middle of the night and, yeah, confirmed that it was. And haven't been able to get in touch with my sister, so we've got grave concerns for her safety.
Amen.
Oh, Dan, and I think, you know, for us, just seeing that vision, we can't imagine you as family, seeing that vision of little Adeline. It's dark, she's outside that church in Mexico there. What would be running through your mind? What is happening with the search for your sister?
Oh, it's definitely ramped up now. Look, we've had that much publicity and noise going on at the moment that the government here is putting in a big effort, and so is the Mexican government. Mm. So we've got a lot of people on the ground searching at the moment. They're chasing up footage of when the vehicle left their hometown, and chasing CCTV footage. They're tracking phones from their last... they're pinging the phone, they call it, to find out their last GPS location of Tani's phone and George's. So, yeah, they found the car. It's been dumped in Cancun, so I'm assuming he's dumped the car and got some other form of transport and he's on the run. So if he's capable of doing that to his daughter, that's what we're so worried about.
That is incredibly, incredibly troubling. We all know that DFAT does a great job and the government in trying to reach out and do whatever they can. But for you right now and your family, what are the next days like for you? What's going to happen?
Well, it's crucial for them. My brother and my mother are on their way to Mexico. We're just trying to get red tape with the esters and that need to be approved to get through the states first. So as soon as that happens, they'll be on their way. We've got all the paperwork and everything to claim Adeline and get her home as soon as possible. So, yeah, we're doing everything we can in that aspect. But as for the search for Tani, we've just got to leave that up to the police and hope that they can get some information and leads and find her as soon as possible.
How are you, Dan?
I'm exhausted. I haven't slept for 3 days, so yeah.
Oh, buddy.
So sorry.
Mate, you have a love and prayers. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you very much.
Tough story, isn't it?